les animaux, les enfants, les peuples au nord, les réfugiés, les nouveaux Canadiens, toi et moi. Autrefois, porter la croix indiquait l'importance de sa religion. Et aujourd'hui au Canada, cette croix a plusieurs formes. Chaque famille canadienne peut protéger son foyer avec ses propres croyances et utiliser sa propre culture pour communiquer ses valeurs. Aujourd'hui, c'est à chacun de nous d'apprendre les leçons du passé pour créer un Canada qui est digne de respect et pour continuer nos plus brillants exploits. Au Canada, nous sommes plus de 40 différents groupes religieux. Nous comptons 18 groupes linguistiques en plus des 56 langues autochtones. Nous sommes vraiment la grande culture pluraliste au Canada. Pour honorer les femmes et les hommes qui portaient l'épée pour leur pays, pour reconnaître notre place sur la planète et pour réfléchir aux possibilités de demain, on va chanter au Canada, mais les deux chantent ensemble la version bilingue. To acknowledge our history with this anthem, today we'll sing the bilingual version of O Canada. Merci pour votre écoute.
War had come, we had failed. But that went on for almost 20 years, and basically the West against the so-called Russian threat never materialized. So my duty, I was a pilot in the Royal Air Force, not the Royal Canadian Air Force, but we had the RCAF in Europe flying fighters for defense. So, what I was flying was this bomber, and it was 80 tons, and notice that doesn't have a fuselage, just a flying wing, which in the late 50s, early 60s was fairly radical. Very good flight. So each week we had to be on standby. We had the bomb, but we never flew with it. We were on the ground, readiness at 15 minutes, and if there was political tension or problems, we would upgrade that until we could be in the cockpit and we could get airborne in 30 seconds. It was quite amazing because we get all engines going and get airborne in 30 seconds. So we had four aircraft and scrambles were quite exciting. So that was 50 years ago, and what we're basically remembering is 100 years ago with the First World War. But it's a case of be prepared, be ready, because we don't need nuclear destruction. They had an acronym MAD, mutually assured destruction, which would have been the case if the balloon had fallen. Thank you very much.
Now we have Abby, Rowan, and Emma reciting In Flanders Fields.
Canadians who gave their lives for our freedom.